Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, it's me, Brigitta, and in the video from today I want to show you my latest journal that I did. And I already showed you a sneak peek in my previous video where I let you see the tags that I already did and two of the big journaling cards I made for this, because I really liked them and I wanted to show them to you. But now they are in the journal and the journal is completed. So yeah, I want to give you a flip through today. And here you see it. As I told in the previous video, it's a ring bound journal. I really like that because then you can vary the size of the pages a little bit easier. And you can take them out when you want to write in your journal. And I think that is really handy. And one reason for me as well is because I always end up making pages that are really embellished. My normal stitched journals turn out really big very quickly, and then it's not easy to write in. And as you can see, this is already also a big journal. So yeah, that's why I prefer to work with rings. And what I liked about these ones was that they are really big, but as well the color of it. So yeah, on the sides, as you can see, I just tied some pieces of tablecloth and some sheer ribbon, and I really like that effect that it gives on the rings. I really like that. I used to make scrapbook mini albums as well myself, and then I tied ribbons and laces to the rings as well, because I just like that look. To hold it together, I just tied it with this piece of lace, and this is the other half of the big piece of lace that I had, and I used the same closure on my Paris journal that I showed a few videos ago. This was the left of the half that was left over, and that I used to tie this journal. And what I also told in the video is that this is the front of the page, but this is not a big sturdy page, so I added that extra. But the front of the page I made from a Dutch doobadoo stencil, and you will not all know that, I think, because it's a Dutch brand, Dutch doobadoo, and they have stencils that you can make cards with, so they are shapes to make cards with. But this one is a mini album stencil, and it comes with two. So this is one, and this is one. And when you draw them and cut them out, you can make it to a mini album or a card with more pages. But I used part of this stencil to make this front part of my journal, and I made it from craft cardstock. That is quite sturdy. It's from Joycrafts, and I edited the beautiful papers of my porch prints, because the main digitals I used for this journal is my porch prints, Grandma's Attic, and I added some images, I think from Artie Mays. I think I added some phrases or words from G. Kerr kids, but the main things are all from the Grandma's Attic. And I really tried to fill this journal with things that remind me of my grandma, my grandmothers. I had to, they already passed away, of course. I am 47 years old, so. And one of my grandmas I lost a long time ago, when I just was in my teenage years. But my other grandma, where I stayed a lot in the weekends when I was younger, because my nieces were there as well really often, I lost a few years ago. And I really filled this journal with memories of them both. So yeah, when I think of grandmas or my grandmas, I think of sewing. They really like to sew. I think of old images. I think of old photographs. I think of fabric. I think of decorating the house. I think of cooking. So yeah, I tried to put a little bit of this in this journal. And now let me start. On top, I added this cute, cute image from the Kids for My Porch Prints, just because I love it so much. And I put it on top of a different piece and a piece of fabric. It's hard to see here, as you can see. And also the base page is from My Porch Prints. Oh, some of the papers are from the Rose Bundle from her as well. So I combined that because they work really well together. This is a fabric flower. It comes on a trim. I just cut off one of it and I attached it here on my front page. And to glue that down, I really like to prefer to use the glossy accents because it dries really hard. This journal phrase is from Prima Marketing. It's from an old paper pad that I had, and I cut it out and I really like it. And I backed it with a banner piece from the same craft cardstock that I had in my stash. And of course, through this journal, I also use a lot of Nouveau drops. And this is the Crystal Drop Antique Rose. So yeah, when you open the first page, it's always hard to show on camera, I think. Then you have a pocket. I made a pocket here and I just added the beautiful papers with a piece of lace and I did some stamping. I stamped throughout this journal as well and I collaged a little bit on the tag from the grandma's attic and I just attached some paper, this beautiful image, some Nouveau drops and the same piece of fabric that I used behind the picture on the front. And here is a beautiful journaling card that comes with the kits. I backed it with this green textured cardstock that I had in my stash. And I attached some lace and some felt as a tab, so that you can easily take it out. And of course, I stitched a lot on here as well. Here I tried two different stitches. Well, you will see throughout my journal, I still need to practice a lot because on the backs, it's not looking so beautiful as I want right now. On the next page, I made a vellum pocket, just from a bag that I had in my stash, and I cut out this thumb hole with a die because it's a little bit scalloped. I hope you can see it. On top, some papers, some trims, and an old image that I had, and I got it from my friend Cindy, one of my crafty sisters. Thank you, Cindy. And I added a strip of blue fabric flowers. I really like that. And the tag that goes inside is this beautiful hair, the rabbits from the kids. And again, the same beautiful cardstock. And I added an applique and a button, a vintage button, as a pull tab to take it out. Of course, you need to put it back carefully. Here on the back, I just made a tuck spot from some ephemera, and here are some journaling cards, really cute images. Then I made a big sturdy front page, as I told in my previous video. I decided to make it a fabric flip because I really love the paper that goes behind here and I didn't want to cover it up with images or something. On top, I just used some beautiful lace for my trim and this plastic trim, and I made it a dangle with a fabric flower and this cute Maria dangle. And this reminds me of my grandma as well. She always wore a necklace, or she had a necklace with a small Maria dangle on it. It was a small one in the color blue, maybe you all know it, and I inherited it from her. I have it downstairs in my living room, where it has a beautiful place. And yeah, that's why I added this one. So yeah, because of the fabric flip does flip up when you put it when you flip the pages, I thought that was annoying. So with this clip, I just clipped the fabric flip tight, and then you can open it, you can write here, add a picture, whatever you want, or leave it like this, because I just love this paper. And with this, it stays in place. Next page, on the back of this sturdy page, I made a big pocket and I added this flower trim on the sides. I really like this one. And again, some beautiful cars from the collection. I also use some graphic paper on the back of some of the journaling cards, so for easy writing. Then this is a page, a big page. This is a page from the kids, and I made an embellishment on the sides. I hope you can see it well. It's an old ephemera piece that I had in my stash. I believe it's from Prima Marketing. A paper flower that I cut out from an old book page. This is a piece. Can you see this white one? It's a border die with cardstock. I made a ruffle from this paper, crepe paper in orange. And this is a postage stamp, a small one from the Rose Bundle. And on the inside is this big tag that I already showed you in a previous video. So we are not going to take a extended look at it, because you can see that in my previous video. When you flip it over, I just made a tuck spots from this beautiful image where I added a butterfly, a bling trim, and a die cut from a white leaf. And on top I made also a tuck spot. And look what I have here. It's so cute. It's a wax seal that was made by my friend Nadezhda, one of my crafty sisters, and I really loved it, and I thought it looked nice here. So beautiful. So just a tuck spot from ephemera and some leftover pieces of cuts of laces and trims, and a small flower that I die-cutted out with a die from my stash. And on the inside, this journaling card and an envelope, and that's a freebie from Artie Mays that I decorated up with this word from G. Kerr, with a piece of vellum in the back, and with some Nouveau drops. And on the inside, just a small ephemera piece. And of course you can add your own things. So yeah, that's that page. And I reinforced all the holes with the cardstock. I used this sponge for it. Maybe you all know it. I hate this thing. I use this on this journal and on one other project, and now it doesn't punch out anymore. So yeah, it's nuts. Normally this is great quality from this brand, from Real Memory Keepers. But this one, I think it's a Monday morning punch or something, because it does not work really well. And now I just can't use it anymore. So yeah, that was not nice. Here is a page I made from a book page from an old sewing book, because also the sewing reminds me of my grandma. When they were younger, they had a shop where they mend clothes and where they sold clothes and baby stuff, diapers of course, when they were a long time ago, and sleeping bags for babies, you name it. So she can make anything. And here I added a library card from the Rose Bundle, and I attached it with the paperclip that I made myself, and a fabric flower in the back, a piece of the ephemera, and this, yeah, you can see it, this fabric flower, this flatback pearl. I really like how this one turned out, so cute. So, and here on the side pocket is this journaling card, the big one that I already showed in the previous video. And on the back side of this page, I just clipped another of the envelopes from Artie Mays, and there is nothing in it. So yeah. Oh, and this is another journaling card with the same cute image I used on the front, and that was here. The next page is a beautiful page with the roses from the Rose Bundle. I stamped here and added the fabric flower, and I did some lace between the pages, because I stitched the page from the kit and the tea stained paper together, and I sandwiched the lace within. So yeah, here I made a flip from graphic paper, and on top I added this beautiful piece that I stitched. I added this very cute applique. I really love this one. And here I added a tag with a dangle that I showed in a different video as well. If I remember, I will link it. I made some fabric dangles like this. I stamped on fabric and gave it color. And this is a word from G. Kerr again. So yeah, and the tag I just embellished with a ticket from Arnie Mays, a text from G. Kerr, some washi, some pearls. So yeah, that goes in this pocket, and the pocket I made from vellum, as you can see. I used an embossing folder on it, and I used a border die. And here was a clock from the Rose Bundle that I used my glossy accents on. A word from my stash and some paper flowers. So I thought it was a really cute page like this. When you flip it, then you have a lot of writing space because this is a tea-dyed page. And I just stenciled on it with the tea-dye distress oxide ink from Tim Holtz. And I stamped with walnut stain these flowers. Next one is again the book page from the sewing book that I have. I added this pocket on top, and that comes with the kit. And on the inside is a tag that I did. Again, a word from G. Kerr. Die cuts that I made with a die from just white cardstock. Postage stamp. Some ribbon. So yeah, that goes in here. With an ephemera piece. And behind the pocket I had this large journaling card, or you can use it as a bookmark. Whatever you want. I really like the image on this one. It's so cute. So yeah, that goes in there. I have to watch my time because, yeah. Okay, here on the side, one of the big journaling cards that I showed in the previous video. Again, with the angel. Here is a tag flip, and I was inspired for this again by G. Kerr. I was a lot inspired by G. Kerr for this ring-bound journal, I must say. Oh, and here on the back I have a pocket. I almost forgot. A pocket with an ephemera piece, and I just decorated it nice. This is two library cards together. When you make this loose, then you can flip it open and then you can write on it. So I will keep it like this. And this is also from the Rose Bundle. Just a small card with pockets. And I have a tag in here. And again, phrases that you can use to write on. Or whatever. And in this is a really small envelope. And even these come out. A small tag and a small card. So yeah, really cute. That goes together in this pocket. Well, here is the tag flip. It just is held together with this piece of ribbon. On front I made a belly band like this. I hope you can see it. On top I added this cute image for decoration. And on the inside just some ephemera pieces and phrases. And the tags I use for this are from Arnie Mays. That's from the free downloadable kits from Arnie Mays that she did a few weeks ago. And that are the tags I used. So when you open it, this flips open. On the inside I just covered the white paper when I printed it out with paper tape that I have. And that's just big tape to wrap your boxes in when you send things out. And on top I added this paper to write on. I stamped. Here are some cards from the Rose Bundle that I just glued on as a pocket and stamped in the corners. And I added the simple tags from the collection with the fabric tab. And here as well. And you can, when you close this one, there is a tuck spot with an ephemera piece and an offcut of an old piece of fabric that I had with an orange flower. Really like that. And in the back is this postage stamp that I glued on as a tuck spot. And on the inside, is a small tag again. So yeah, that's like this. I will quickly put it together. Now, tying on camera is not easy. Well, I will put it back later on. Then the next page is the same as a few pages back, with the same cluster, just with a different ephemera piece. I did some stenciling again here with a beautiful stencil. And here is the other big tag that you already saw. So yeah, Then when you flip it, just a pocket I made from an ephemera piece. I added it on book page, and you can, when everything is out, you can flip it open and you have some secret writing space. Here just some embellishing with things from my stash. And on the inside, oh, I must say, this green paper that I stitched together with the writing paper from the kit is just scrapbooking paper that I had in my stash. This is again a journaling card that I made. That goes in here. This is a simple card. And this is a coin envelope that I colored with distress inks. I stamped on it, added these images. Here is a piece of a label from Tracy Fox. And on the inside, what have I in the inside? Just a simple tag for some hidden journaling as well. And that goes in there. So yeah, that's this one. Then we have a blank page again, because I just love these papers with the roses. And I just added some washi tape on some places. And on top is a pocket that I made. I made a double one. I already used one in my Paris journal. It's also from the rose bundle from My Porch Prints. It already comes like this. You just cut it out and make it fold it over and make a pocket. On the back, I just attached some graphic paper and I stenciled this rose on. And on the inside, oh, look how beautiful it is. Here I embellished it with lace, with this trim, with a crochet flower for my friend Patricia, one of my crafty sisters, and a piece of cuts and a beautiful flower. And on the inside, just a journaling card, an envelope from Artie Mays with some extras on, and this beautiful clock from the rose bundle. I embellished it. Really like this one, and when you open it, you have some writing space as well. So yeah, that's the, yeah, I don't know how they are called, the pocket tag, I think. And I have it with this pink paper clip. Here I added pink laces on the sides. Here is just tea dyed copy paper with stenciling and stamping again. Really love the effect of the tea dyeing. And here there is an envelope that I altered. I cut out this frame with my die, added this cute little boy. I stenciled on it in the back, I stamped on it. I'll try to show it up close. I added laces and appliques, beautiful flower of a butterfly that I made with a die. I cut it out of paper and then I did the second layer out of vellum and I embellished it with the trim. And here is a word from G. Kerr again, and I added it on top of a label that I received from Nikki Edigan. It's one of the grungy labels from her. And in the back we have also a pocket that I already had. It's from music paper. I got it from someone, I don't know from who, but I really loved it. I just embellished it with this paper flag and with Let Your Dreams Blossom from G. Kerr. And on the inside, a tag with a fly. So I'm back. My memory card was full on my phone, so I had to switch them out. Where was I? Yeah, I wanted to show you this tag. It's a tag that I coffee dyed a long time ago, and I just added this ephemera piece and made this embellishment on top. And you can write in the back if you want, and that holds the envelope shut. On the flap of the envelope, some trims. And on the inside, and I'm not going to take it out, but it's just a journaling card, really simple. And you can see the paper here. It's just a simple card with the paper from the rose bundle, because I liked it as a background for this boy. So yeah, really simple. That is there. Then the next page, again, beautiful papers with washi tape. And I added this envelope as a flip. So, on the envelope, I just used a book page that I had in my stash. I made a I tore out a pocket from paper, stamped on it. And on the inside, some ephemera pieces again. And Here is the pocket, of course, with a journaling card, and I attach the tab on it. Really simple. And that goes in here. Well, here. And when you flip it like this, you have a flip up here as well, with a writing space, book page, stamping, some stitching. I really like it. And here I attached small things to it, so some piece of trim. And I really liked this postage stamp. And I made a teeny tiny little tag, as you can see. And here I added one of my fabric dangles, and I just glued on this plastic flower on top. And it's held there with this teeny tiny paper clip. I will put that back after the video because it's a little bit fiddly. Lace again. Some tea dyed paper that has stenciling on it, with my stencil from Tim Holtz and a different stencil. I really like this. And then we have a page again with a beautiful paper, but I made a belly band here on top. I hope you can see it. It's just cardstock with design paper and this trim. And I made a booklet, and this booklet I followed the tutorial from Yvonne Preston. So you can flip this up, then you have a lot of writing space. I just embellished the front with the saying from Jeeker, a tag with a bread so you can swirl it around. I added this applique, piece of fabric and a fabric flower. And on the back there is a pocket with paper flower and some decoration. Stenciling I did everywhere as well here. And there is a tag on the back, coffee stained as you can see. Added pieces of the paper, of the lace. And I stamped on it with an Art Journey stamp set that I have with the bottles. I really like these. And added some stickles, some green stickles. The green stickles that I used is this one. The eucalyptus. It's a soft green stickles. And that tag goes in the back of the pockets. And then you can add this to the front, and this just hangs over with the flap. So yeah, I really like how this looks. It was a really nice simple tutorial to follow, and it gives a lot of extra writing space. Here is again tea stained paper with stenciling, and here is also an envelope. That's an envelope from Artie Mays that I just altered. And what I did here on the front of the envelope is I just made a collage with this cute image that I have from my friend Cindy. I put it on a scallop die cut that I have from my Spellbinders die. I added the same fabric in the back that I used throughout. Here is a tear strip from Nikki Adigan, one of my winnings from her giveaway of the COVID-19 giveaway, where she gave away 19 days prizes to people. Dig it was all. I added this bow from Twine. Here is a paper doily die cut that I glued here. In the back is an ephemera piece of the grandma's attic. A beautiful butterfly that's from Artie Mays, I believe. And here is a metal piece that I had in my stash that I used on the body. So I really liked how this cluster came out. When you flip it with this golden envelope, some ephemera is in it, and that's flashcards, one of the digitals I want from Nikki Adigan again. And here is a beautiful rose tag, and I just embellished it with this, and this is, I believe, from Patricia or Nadezhda. They gifted that to me, and it's tea stained as you can see, and I just glued it on. I really liked it here with the dangles on top, some lace with some twine, and in the back graphic paper, a small duck spot with the clock and with this cute piece. So yeah, that's in there. I printed these envelopes out a long time ago just on the normal 8 grams copy paper, so I reinforced it with washi tape and with this to make it a little bit sturdier. And on the inside, two journaling cards. This is an ephemera piece that I added a doily from my stash, and this beautiful fussy cut image. And Moments is from G. Kerr. I backed it with coffee and tea stained paper and stamped it. And here another one, another rip strip from Nikki Adigan. Musings by Nikki on Etsy, and coffee stained paper. So yeah, a lot of writing space and hidden writing space in this journal. So that goes back here. And then we already come to the last page, to the back cover page. Beautiful paper. Oh, and I did not cover the front and the back with fabric, so just with paper. So I gessoed the sides a little bit to hide the brown cardstock, and I just like gesso on the sides. So a big pocket or side pocket with extra laces, and a big row of the Nouveau drops. Love this paper as well from the Grandma's Etiquette. So gorgeous and vintage grungy. And again, some journaling cards for writing space. So yeah, that was all the whole journal that I want to show to you. I hope you like it. I had a lot of fun creating it. I really liked to work with the beautiful papers and ephemera pieces from all the talented ladies here on YouTube and with their Etsy shops. So yeah, if you have any questions about it, please ask them on my private email address. You can find it in the description box below. And I hope you will be back for my next video. And my next video probably will be a show and tell again from this. I will give you a sneak peek. It's a small folio I made together with my crafty sisters. We all made one. And it was designed by Carmen van Lokven, one of my crafty sisters. And we made it together on an online crafty meetup, because we cannot see each other right now, of course. So we did a virtual crafting day. We made this beautiful folio with the butterflies in blue paper kit from Digital Kit from Artie Mays. But I still have to decorate everything on the inside, so I cannot show it to you. So yeah, this was it. I'm going to stop right now. I'm going to take a drink, because I have a dry throat from all the talking. I have my favorite drinks ready. I really love the cinnamon cola zero. And yeah, thank you for watching. I hope you have a great rest of the evening. Bye bye.